Something that's unique here about Singapore is that all the high voltage lines are buried underground. When you look around, you don't see any power lines on poles. What that means is that in buildings, commercial buildings, residential buildings, that the transformer rooms typically are on the ground floor. So what we're going to do today is to go into one of these high voltage transformer rooms where they have three-phase transformers, and we're going to see what's inside. One of the first things I noticed when I walked into this room is that it sounds a little bit dangerous. I can hear a faint buzzing at 100 hertz. 100 hertz here in Singapore is twice the line frequency, which is 50 hertz. The reason why sometimes transformers tend to buzz a little bit is because the magnetic field inside the transformer is changing from strong to weak to strong to weak at a frequency of 100 hertz, or twice the line frequency. And when magnetic fields start to change like that, things can sometimes tend to vibrate, and it's usually nothing to be concerned about at all. You might notice that the side of this transformer here says silicone oil. The coils down inside of a transformer are not just exposed to the air, they're actually immersed in oil. The reason why silicone oil is used instead of mineral oil, by the way, is because silicone oil is non-flammable. I mentioned before that the high voltage lines here in Singapore are buried underground. So what we can see here in this red cable coming up to us out of the ground is a three-phase 22 kilovolt high voltage line, and this transformer is going to change that into the 230 volt to neutral that we use in our daily lives. This is a 22 kilovolt line, and 22 kilovolt here refers to the phase-to-phase voltage. So this is a three-phase line, and this is a three-phase transformer. Although this particular substation is a 22 kilovolt substation, here in Singapore we also have 66 kilovolt substations, 230 kilovolt substations, and we even have a couple of 400 kilovolt substations. Mixture of high and low voltages within any network is very typical in a power distribution system. So let's take a look at one of these transformers in a little bit more detail. We can see a display indicating oil level, and of course that's very important to monitor from time to time to make sure that the oil is not leaking out. We can see on the sides of the transformer here fins, and of course that's very important for heat dissipation. We don't want these transformers to get hot. And finally, we have the nameplate, and this is always very important because it tells us what kind of transformer it is. Let's take a look at this nameplate in detail. We can see here, of course, the rated power. This is a 2500 kilovolt amp transformer, and it's important here to notice that volt amp is used instead of watts, and the reason for that is because we're monitoring or measuring the power passing through the transformer rather than power burned up or dissipated in the transformer. We can see here the rated voltages. We see that on the high voltage side, this is a 22,000 volt transformer. And on the low voltage side, we see the numbers 433Y/250. This indicates that there's a Y connection, and you might notice it says no load at normal tapping. When we actually have loads attached to the secondary of this transformer, then the voltages would be reduced to about 400 and our nominal 230 volt line voltage. Down here at the bottom, we can see how it's connected. At the high voltage side, I see A, B, and C, the three phases coming in. And here at the low voltage side at the top, I can see that we have three phases plus a neutral connection. One of the most important things on this nameplate is the connection symbol, and I see DYN11. The D is capitalized, and the reason it's capitalized is because it refers to the primary or high voltage side of the transformer. D stands for delta, Y stands for Y. So on the primary side, we have a delta connection. On the secondary or low voltage side, we have a Y connection. The N indicates that there's a neutral, and the number 11 allows us to measure the phase difference between the high and low voltage sides. The reason why there's this 11 is because there's a phase difference between the lines coming out of the secondary and the lines going into the primary. We know that because this is a delta star transformer, that the secondary is not going to be in phase with the primary. The number 11, though, refers to the face of a clock. So if you imagine that the high voltage side of the transformer is a hand at 12 o'clock, and the secondary side is a hand at 11 o'clock, then converting these hours into degrees, we can see that there's a 330 degree space separation between primary and secondary. Equivalently, we could say that the low voltage side lags the high voltage side by 330 degrees, or that the low voltage side leads the high voltage side by 30 degrees. Well, I hope you've enjoyed seeing the inside of the substation and seeing what one of these three-phase transformers looks like. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.